Hello and welcome to Man Plays Game. Studio Koba made a game called Narita Boy, and I played it. Narita Boy is... well, it's... a Metroidvania. No. It's a brawler. No. Techno, acid, fantasy tale told through a video game? Well, whatever snappy description you can throw at this bad boy, I think we can all agree that it is captivating. Narita Boy sports some beautiful visuals coupled with some groovy synthwave. The spectacle is a delivery system for what you could consider a classic medieval fantasy adventure with some Tron Legacy thrown in for good measure. A seemingly simple, multi-layered world unfolds as you solve puzzles, climb walls, and swing your sword. And the details found within the beautiful landscapes and cityscapes lead to secrets that reveal even more of the world Studio Koba has created. I want to clarify that the Tron comment, while valid, was said in jest. There is more to this story than a rip-off of a dead-end Disney franchise. You play as a video game-obsessed kid from Old York in the 80s who gets sucked into the game world to restore the creator's memories and save the digital kingdom. After acquiring the Technoblade in an Excalibur-like moment, you proceed to slash and dash your way through the different areas, working your way to the central core where the villain Him awaits you. What helps set this apart from being a cliché is the detail in the writing. Clichés usually don't take much effort, it's kind of the point of using a cliché. The writing in this game has had apparent effort put into the manner in which the programs speak, the way the world also reflects the creator's persona and values, not to mention the creator's own memories are all evidence that the story started somewhere a bit more personal than it would first appear to be. However, the story is more about the destination than the journey. The pacing is steady due to a regimented to-do list that sends players going from room to room just checking things off. It becomes apparent early in the game that being told, "Now you have to travel to the yellow beam to the first house of the Trichroma," sounds cool, but then there's actually doing it. The gameplay was just entertaining enough to get me from one story point to the other. Exploring this world, I would find the screen stopping in an empty room so I could kill five waves of enemies or a series of platforms that are peppered with baddies. It ended up feeling like a brawler mixed with Mega Man X, with the slashing sword dashing in a rechargeable super move that can clear the screen. While I enjoy the arcade feel of combat, I ended up liking platforming a little bit more. Narita Boy is a very snappy mover with a lot of overshoot. Getting used to controlling this character reminded me that the main character just became Narita Boy and has to get used to all this power himself. If that was intentional, kudos to you, Koba. While climbing and air dashes made traversing the world more enjoyable, which is important because a lot of the gameplay is moving from A to B, backtracking, and solving puzzles. There is really only one type of puzzle, too. The player uses gateways to get to the other areas that require a code composed of unique symbols found in the game world. You find these symbols in the environment around you, you plug it into the portal, progress to the next area. While the execution of the puzzle is satisfactory, I found the variety wanting. Not just the puzzles had a variety issue, there is a set pattern to the game progression as well. Go to the new area, find discs to unlock the doors until you get to the end of the area, defeat the boss, rinse, and repeat. There are very few exceptions to this, and even then, it does not veer off track that much. What I'm trying to say is, the gameplay could have been a standout feature, something innovative, or unique, or surprising, but instead was simply competent in its purpose of getting the character from one point to another and showcase the beautiful worlds, and oh, how beautiful they are. The game has gained acclaim for its visual style, pixel art, and recreating the look of a CRT monitor. Other games I have reviewed do this too, but there's something about the whole visual package that makes it hard to look away. The use of color, the style of the pixel art, the special effects, the animation, and the depth added to all of these through Unity is a winning combination. Each screen is a lovely piece of pixel art with attention spent on every detail. The Digital Kingdom's inhabitants are varied and the monochromatic vistas are stunning. The soundtrack rises to meet the quality of the graphics. Moody synthwave and upbeat synthpop punctuate scenes of drama and of fun. There is care given to the tone for each area, especially the creator's memories, where the overall themes can be heard in each small variation of each individual track. I have nothing but good things to say about Narita Boy's presentation. While having some gripes about not going above and beyond, I do not regret playing this game. The visuals, music, and story were interesting enough for me to play all the way through. The main issue is that the nostalgia mining gameplay doesn't bring anything new to the table. It's just playing the hits, so to speak. This doesn't hurt the game, but it certainly doesn't help. I'm gonna give Narita Boy a 3 out of 5, meaning if you never get tired of hacking, slashing, dashing, and mini fetch quests, you should give this game a try. If you, like me, were drawn in by the stellar visuals, maybe wait for a sale before uploading your code into the Trichroma.
Did you already reach the core? Tell the real world about it in the comments. Thanks for watching, and take care.